وليس من عمل يقربكم إلى النار إلا وقد نهيتكم عنه. وعلى هذا جاءت الكثير من الأحاديث النبوية تبين لنا طرق الفلاح في هذه الدنيا، كما تبين لنا طرق الغواية والضلال حتى نتجنبها. ففي خطبتي لهذا اليوم أردت أن أسلط الضوء على هذه الطرق التي ذكرها رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم في حديثه، وهذا هو موضوع خطبتي لهذا اليوم، طرق الفلاح وطرق الهلاك من المنظور النبوي. Brothers and sisters, Allah سبحانه وتعالى sent His messenger Muhammad, peace be upon him, sent him to all mankind, sent him as a teacher and as a guide. His prophetic teachings do encompass all aspects of life. He did not leave any matter without explaining to us the best way in order to follow it. And this way will secure happiness for us in this dunya and make us away from the punishment of Allah in the Akhirah. This is what he mentioned in his hadith narrated by the companion Abdullah, the son of Mas'ud, that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, there is no act that makes you get the pleasure of Allah, but I demand you to take. And there is no act that makes you get the displeasure of Allah that I demand you to shun away. Based on this, many ahadith were revealed by Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, telling us the good ways in order to adopt them and the bad ways in order to avoid them. So in my today khutbah, I would like to elaborate on these days from prophetic perspectives that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned in his hadith narrated and reported by Imam al-Tabarani, that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, ثَلَاثٌ مُهْلِكَاتٌ وَثَلَاثٌ مُنَجِّيَاتٌ. أَمَّا الْمُهْلِكَاتُ فَشُحٌّ مُطَاعٌ وَهَوًى مُتَّبَعٌ وَإِعْجَابُ الْمَرْءِ بِنَفْسِهِ. وأما المنجيات فالعدل بالغضب والرضا والقصد بالفقر والغنى وخشية الله في السر والعلن. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned in his hadith three acts that are destructive. Number one, شح المطاع, obeyed stinginess. And number two, هوى المتبع. هوى المتبع, for the desire. And number three, وإعجاب المرء بنفسه, self-admiration. And on the other hand, three are constructive. Number one, العدل في الغضب والرضا, to do justice whether you are pleased or displeased. And number two, والقصد في الفقر والغنى, to seek moderation whether you are rich or poor. And number three, وخشية الله في السر والعلانية, and to be fearful of Allah in private and in public. Brothers and sisters, this hadith is talking about two divergent acts. The first belong to those which are destructive. Number one, شح المطاع. شح المطاع, obey stinginess. شح is to refrain, is to refrain from what Allah blessed you with. The stingy person is always trying to withhold what Allah has given him. Allah has given him money, for example, wealth. He tries not to spend in the way of Allah. And this shock muta made the person always obedient to his shock, which is telling him, never do anything because this is the money that you work hard in order to earn. And this contradicts with Iman, because Iman is telling us to give priority over priority of our deen over our money. But Shuh is telling us the opposite. Therefore, they are not meeting together, as Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, لا يجتمع الشح والإيمان في قلب عبد المؤمن أبدا. Faithfulness and stinginess never come into the heart of the believer at all. Brothers and sisters, the hadith here is very clear, telling us to do something for the sake of Allah. And we just heard the announcement that the parking lot in the Islamic Center is in need of support. And all of us, we should always do something for the house of Allah. Allah Ta'ala is telling us in the Quran, in Surah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, ha antum tud'awna litunfiqu fi sabilillah fa minkum man yabkhal wa man yabkhal fa innama yabkhal 'an nafsihi. Allah is saying in Surah Muhammad, you are invited to spend in the sake, for the sake of Allah, and some of you are stingy. Those who are not spending, they are doing that against themselves. Let us, brothers and sisters, do today something. Whatever we are able to afford, try to put them in the sadaqah or in the box or CD office, please. This act number one, which Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is telling us to pay attention and to shun away from. And act number two, follow desire. Hawa al-muntaba. What is hawa? Hawa is a negative lust. It is, let me say, lustful inclination of the soul. Hawa is always telling us to do something that may anger Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Hawa is telling us in the Fajr prayer when the Muazzin is saying, As-salatu khayru min al-nawm. Our hawa is telling us, keep sleeping. We miss Fajr prayer. Hawa is telling us when a woman passing by with revealing dress, the hawa is telling us, enjoy looking. Hawa is telling us when there is business transaction that make you earn unlawful money, hawa is telling you, no problem. But the good Muslim always in struggle against his hawa. When his hawa try to control him, he gives no chance. And he says, well, inni akhafu an asaytu rabbi adhaba yawmin azim. I fear Allah if I did something wrong. Therefore, he controls his hawa and never let his hawa control him. Wa amma man khafa maqama rabbihi wa naha an-nafsa 'anil hawa fa inna al-jannata hiya al-ma'wa. Those who fear Allah and curb their nafs from hawa, Allah is fixing a great reward for you. It is Jannah. The third destructive act that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is telling us is i'jabu al-mar'i bi nafsi. Self-admiration. Self-admiration means that the person is taking much pride in himself. He believes that he is above others. He is opinionated, and he thinks that all people's views are wrong except his. And he wants people to follow him. This is what Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us, a kind of takabbur or arrogance, as he said sallallahu alaihi wasallam, al-kibar, al-kibru, ghamdu al-haqqi, batarul haqqi wa ghamdu al-nas. Arrogance is to reject the truth and look down upon people. This is what the self-admiration makes in the person. اعجاب المرء بنفسه. And this negative immoral quality makes the person oppressor, as Fir'aun, which Allah mentioned in the Quran, ما أريكم إلا ما أرى وما أهديكم إلا سبيل الرشاد. Allah mentioned some immoral quality about Fir'aun, who was saying to his people, I want you to follow the way that I see correct, and I always guide you to the straight path. What kind of guidance will come to us from Fir'aun? Fir'aun passed away, but many Fara'een came after him. And this is our problem nowadays, that people, oppressors, are opinionated, believing that they are above others. These three destructive acts that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is telling us to avoid. Let me, my brothers and sisters, mention another three but constructive acts that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned in his hadith. In my second khutbah, kullu ma tasma'un wa astaghfirullah li wa lakum wa ya fawza mustaghfirin. I kindly ask my brothers to receive your word and give a place for those who are behind. Jazakumullah. In alhamdulillah, nahmaduhu wa nasta'inu wa nasta'hidu wa nasta'firuh wa na'udhu billahi min shururi anfusina wa min sayyiati a'malina. Man yahdihillahu fahuwa al-muhtad wa man yudlil falan tajid lahu waliyan murshida. عباد الله أوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى الله وأحثكم على طاعته وأنهاكم ونفسي عن مخالفته وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده وأصلي وأسلم على من لا نبي بعده. أما بعد، رحمة محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم mentioned in his hadith reported by Imam al-Tabarani three destructive acts, and on the other hand he also mentioned three constructive acts, and he advises us sallallahu alaihi wasallam to adopt these three acts in our everyday behavior. Act number one, al-adl bil ghadab wa ridha, to show justice whether you are pleased or displeased. Good Muslim always demonstrates justice. Even if he is wronged, he exercises justice against himself. All of us know that emotional people, when they give decisions, their decisions always fluctuate because they are under the mood, under the influence of their emotions. But good Muslim doesn't let his emotions not do justice. He always tries his best to do justice even with his enemies. Even with this, he may differ with them. He tries his best to do justice. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا كُونُوا قَوَّامِينَ لِلَّهِ شُهَدَاءَ بِالْقِسْطِ وَلَا يَجْرِمَنَّكُمْ شَنَآنُ قَوْمٍ عَلَى أَلَّا تَعْدِلُوا. اعدلوا هو أقرب التقوى. Allah mentioned in Surah Maidah, addressing the believers, saying, all who believe, always do justice. And don't let your hatred to other people prevent you from exercising justice, from establishing justice. Do justice, you will be close to taqwa. Act number two is moderation. والقصد في الفقر والغنى. To seek moderation, whether you are rich or poor. The teachings of Islam want Muslim to always be moderate Muslim. Be moderate Muslim never goes to the other extreme. He tries always his best to show moderation in all of his daily affairs. The excellent moral quality that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described his chosen people whom he named Ibad al-Rahman. In Surah Al-Furqan, وَعِبَادُ الرَّحْمَنِ الَّذِينَ يَمْشُونَ عَلَى الْأَرْضِ, he mentioned great qualities of his chosen servants. One of the greatest qualities that Allah mentioned about his chosen is that they are always seeking moderation. وَالَّذِينَ إِذَا أَنْفَقُوا لَمْ يُسْرِفُوا وَلَمْ يَقْتَرُوا وَلَمْ يَقْتُرُوا وَكَانَ بَيْنَ ذَلِكَ قَوَامًا. Those are my great servants. When they spend, they don't go to the other extreme. وَلَا تَجْعَلْ يَدَكَ مَغْلُولَةً إِلَىٰ عُنُقِكَ وَلَا تَبْسُطْهَا كُلَّ الْبَسْطِ فَتَقْعُدَ مَلُومًا مَحْسُورًا. Allah mentioned the same quality in Surah. In Surah Isra, never go to the other extreme. I would like to take this opportunity to mention that we need to implement this quality, especially in the wedding. When we are in the wedding party, we must try our best to be people of moderation. And mahr, dowry, must always be in the moderation part, moderation path. When we have our children feel happy in this wedding party or others, always we need to see moderation. The last constructive act that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned in his hadith, خشيه الله والعلانية, to fear Allah in private and in public. Brothers and sisters, let us face it. Fearing Allah in public is great. And alhamdulillah, we do. We come to the masjid to pray. We come to read Quran. We get together and we never disobey Allah. We are fearful of Him. This is great. But still, there is a greater quality, is to fear Allah when you are alone. Good Muslim is the Muslim who doesn't have a double standard character, behaving well in front of people, but when he is alone, he deviates from this straight implementation. To show us the danger of this double standard character, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam put his sahaba, لَأَعْلَمَنَّ أَقْوَامًا مِنْ أُمَّتِي يَكُونَ بِحَسَنَاتٍ أَمْثَالَ الْجِبَالِ فَيَجْعَلَهَا اللَّهُ هَبَاءً مَنْثُورًا. ثم قرأ قوله تعالى, وَقَدِمْنَا إِلَى مَا عَمِلُوا مِنْ عَمَلٍ فَجَعَلْنَاهُ هَبَاءً مَنْثُورًا. قال الصحابة, من هم يا رسول الله؟ صفهم لنا. قال, هم منكم ولهم حظ من الليل غير أنهم إذا خلوا إلى محارم الله انتهكوها. He said صلى الله عليه وسلم a great hadith that we need to consider, and allow me to mention it with the conclusion of my khutbah. He said, I know some people of my ummah, they accumulate hasanat, credits, as huge as the mountains. Then in the day of judgment, Allah will scatter all what they had accumulated in the dunya from hasanat. The Sahaba were shocked. They told him, O Prophet of Allah, who are these people? He said, Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, these people from my ummah, they come to Taraweeh prayer, they come to the masjid, they pray, they read Quran. But when they are alone, when they are in private, they violate the teachings of Allah. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا وسلموا وباركوا عليه سمعنا وأطعنا اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما صليت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما باركت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد اللهم فارج الهم كاشف الغم مجيب دعوة المضطرين رحمن الدنيا والآخرة ورحمهما نسألك رحمة من عندك تحقن بها دماء المسلمين في سوريا نسألك رحمة من عندك تحقن بها دماء المسلمين في العراق واليمن وليبيا وباكستان وأفغانستان وفي كل مكان يا رب العالمين يذكر فيه اسمك وتقام به شعائرك اللهم إليك المشتكى وأنت السؤال نسألك يا رب العالمين موجبات رحمتك وعزائم مغفرتك والغنيمة من كل بر والسلامة من كل إثم والفوز بالجنة والنجاة من النار يا رب العالمين لا تدع لنا في هذه الساعة المباركة ذنبا إلا غفرته ولا هما إلا فرجته ولا دعاء إلا استجبت لنا به يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم ولا مريضا إلا شفيته وعافيته ولا ميتا إلا ورحمته يا أرحم الراحمين يا رب العالمين وأقم الصلاة إن الصلاة تنهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر ولذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله